Friends, good afternoon. It is a joy to welcome you to the First Presbyterian Church of Plymouth. My name is the Reverend Emily Campbell, and on behalf of the entire church, we welcome you, and we are thrilled to be able to share with you today this concert celebrating Sue Scott's 40 years of ministry here at this church. 40 years ago, in September 1983, Sue Scott was called by God to serve here in this church. She was 37 years old at the time and became the organist during the ministry of the Reverend Phil McGee. Sue's ministry has never been limited to just the organ, which you will hear today, or to the bells, which you will also hear. But Sue has been an incredible gift to the families of this church as she has presided in music over so many marriages and funerals here at the church. And I know she has brought comfort, joy, and peace through her music. Sue's ministry expanded in this church when she began the Joyful Ringers 17 years ago, and Sue has served not only this group as the director, but in so many ways a pastor as well. It's a joy to share with you that Sue Scott is the longest serving employee in the history of this congregation. And I am absolutely delighted to say that she's not done yet. This is not a retirement celebration, rather a celebration of Sue's ongoing ministry. Earlier today in our worship service here at the church, we presented Sue with several gifts. I'll be sharing a little bit more about that later in our service. But I can say to you, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that this church is stronger for her ministry. Today, it is a gift to offer this concert, which at 2 o'clock is not only a gift, which means we can move out the organ so you can fully see Sue and all that she does, but it's a gift because we can invite other members of the community who themselves had worship services this morning to come in and join with us in honoring this ministry. And so I invite you to sit back, enjoy all that you are going to hear, but let us first do exactly what Sue would have us do, which is always start this service with praise. And so I invite you at this time to please pray with me. Gracious God, we praise you today, for you are the creator of all good gifts, for the blessing of music, for the joy of fellowship, for the comfort and encouragement of one another. We praise you. We praise you for the gift of Sue Scott's ministry among us, and we pray that this concert in all of its forms would be a blessing to you. Open up our hearts and our minds, Lord, to draw near to you, even as you draw near to us. This we ask in the strong name of Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen. And now, hear these words from Scripture. This is Psalm 150. Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and lyre. Praise him with timbrel and dancing. Praise him with strings and pipe. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. I am now going to turn things over to the woman of the hour, to Sue.
This wasn't supposed to be about Sue Scott. However, I want to thank all of my friends, my bell ringers, and all of my musician friends who are participating today. We wouldn't be having this without them. They are so, so special. The very first thing on the program you'll notice is a hymn. So yes, you are going to sit back for the rest of the program, but right now, you're going to participate. And so hymn number 72 in the red hymnals, and I'm going to tell you how to sing it. How about that? I get to be the director instead of the directee. So we are going to sing this like you were saying the words. So the tempo's going to be a little faster. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning from thee. So you see the phrasing. We're going to move right through it. And between the second and the third verse, we're going to change keys. I promise I will keep all the original harmonies for all of you that are singing harmony. But we will change keys. And at the end of the last chorus, we will slow down. So I get to say, follow me.
Thank you.
one quick word about this organ before Cheryl plays. Because the horn and the keyboard don't play in the same key, it either meant Cheryl had to transpose it or I had to transpose it. When I was growing up, there was no such thing as a pipe organ that transposed. This beautiful instrument, however, has this lovely little dial over there, and I can just change it to whatever key we need it to be in, so that I can play what's written and don't have to rewrite the whole thing, and she can play what's written and doesn't have to rewrite the whole thing. So this is one of the marvels of this combination hybrid pipe and digital organ.
Thank you. Thank you.
So as you see, I have a wide variety of very talented friends. Very talented friends. Eileen, who rings bells all by herself, I just look at that and go, there's no way. She's so gifted. Cello, Karen Danke, was a little girl when I came here.
Were you born?
I did, barely.
She was barely born when I came here. She was a baby, in other words. And she came up through the cherub choirs, the little kids' choirs, ended up directing the teenage choir at that time, and is quite a skilled cellist, pianist, organist, you name it. Wanda, I met through the community band, and she is such a delight, such a dear friend, and such a great flautist, I believe they're called. And Jim Stolt is the pastor down at Praise Community Church. He is not only a wonderful pastor, he is an amazing tenor. And he is going to show you a very big variety of music this afternoon, everything from opera to Broadway. So next is Jim, as I change the organ a little bit.
While she's changing the organ, I'm going to say something and broke the protocol a little bit. I have to tell you, this lady is probably one of my biggest cheerleaders. She has been such an encouragement to me as a young pastor and as a musician. You know, going into the pastorate, that's really been my focus. And she's like, no, you are still a musician, you know. And she allows me to sing stuff like this, you know, which is really fun. I haven't sung this since college. And so thank you, Sue, and thank you so much for being such a good friend and encourager.
Vivere voglio a te fedel. Sì, sì.
I told you. to the really fun part of the ding-a-lings. Ladies. Thank you. it was fun. I didn't say it was easy. So in that piece, it's triplets against eighth notes. So it's three, it's like patting your head and rubbing your tummy at the same time. It's crazy, but they've managed to do that. And they performed it for the Area 5 Festival at the Grand Hotel in 2015. So we've played at the Grand in 2015, 2018, and 2022. And we've been so blessed to be able to do that. The next piece is written by Matthew Compton. He was 16 years old when he won his first composition award. And now, at the ripe old age of 23, he has written another composition. This one has just won the Area 5 Composition Award. So we're very happy to be playing this today. Beautiful Savior.
Thank you.
The next piece is one of our favorite ones. We've played it at festivals. We may have played it here even on a Sunday morning the other night when we practiced it. I took it a little too slow, evidently. And they said, we'd like to take it faster. Okay. So I started it, and they just took off. I mean, I could have walked away, and they just, it was just going. So today we'll see where we end up. Well, we'll see. It went okay this morning, but sometimes it gets to be a freight train, and it just runs away, and I just sit down and watch them. So much fun. They just take off and they do their own thing, and I just stand back and watch because they are amazing.
Friends, before Sue plays her final number for us, I would like to invite all of you to join us immediately following the end of this concert downstairs in our dining room and fellowship hall, where we have a reception all ready and waiting with some wonderful food in which to honor Sue. And you are all most warmly invited to this reception. Before we get there, I just want to recap that this morning in our worship service, where we had the opportunity as a congregation to honor Sue, we presented her with gifts. We brought gifts from the children of the church. We brought gifts from the chancel choir and gifts from the HR and worship committee. And there were two other gifts which we thought would be appropriate to share with everyone here today. And so I'm going to invite Pam Smith, who is here representing the Joyful Ringers, to share the gift that they brought to Sue today.
Front and center, and as you always tell us, we know you're ready when your hands are at your side and you're looking at us. So you heard she was our director almost 17 years ago, and I don't know if you knew what you were in for then, but you've since found out a lot of Type A personalities, and sometimes you've even said it's like herding cats. Over those many years, many hands have rung with the Joyful Ringers, but it's been your hands that have led, taught, supported, lifted up, prayed, and been our constant force. We share many memories, some sad, but many more adventurous and heart full as one family in Christ ringing to His glory. You've heard about the festivals that we've celebrated in Ohio, in Indiana, and as far as Louisville, Kentucky. Yes, 5 days before the pandemic of 2020 broke out, we were together with 600 ringers celebrating. And our favorite, that Grand Hotel on Mackinac Island. We've also done performances with other local churches, the Livonia Choir, Outside in the Wind, and even traveled as friends to Rehoboth Beach. It's that knit of a family. But we're still looking for volunteers, so don't ever be shy. Come join us. You not only took us on physical excursions, but you took us on mindful ones as well. You challenged us to tackle the music when we thought it not possible, like Celtic Praise. You ask us to be bigger and bigger, and then go away. You highly encourage us to count, watch for key changes, tempo changes, to not push you and take you to the river with runaway eighth notes. And as a director really hopes for, look up occasionally and follow you. So again, it's on our pleasure and honor that we celebrate you, because you are awesome. And we're gonna gift you this present that you saw this morning, but some people may not.
You all have to see this because it's so beautiful. It is hand bells all over it, and bell notations all over it.
And it is signed. There's a label in the other corner. It's signed by all the Joyful Ringers.
How cool is that? Everybody's signature in the corner, and over here, Sue Scott celebrating 40 years of music at FPCP from the Joyful Ringers. And today's date. It's so beautiful. Thank you so much.
The other gift that we gave, I gave it to Sue, and I have a feeling it's at Sue's house right now. But what I can tell you is that it was a mock-up of what is currently being made at this very moment as a gift from our entire congregation. There is a cast iron and bronze plaque being made that says on it, "Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth." Psalm 100, verse 1, honoring Sue Scott, making music for God for 40 years, 1983 through 2023. And that plaque will go up right beside this door in the sanctuary and will be a permanent feature of our church. God, for the gift and blessing of Sue. Let's pray. Gracious God, we thank you for the gift of music and the way that it stirs our hearts and minds. For all the music offered here today, we praise you and thank you for ministering to the deep recesses of our souls. We thank you once again today for the blessing of Sue Scott and for her ministry among us. We thank you for Sue and all of her friendships and connections that have brought so many talented performers to us here today. Thank you to each of them for sharing their own talents with us. We ask, dear God, now your blessing on them and on Sue's ministry going forward. May she continue to make beautiful music that forever reflects your glory and grace. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. And now I'm going to let Sue have the final word, but as a blessing on this concert, let me just say, I invite you at the end to not only join us downstairs, but depart from here today in peace and in joy. And as you go, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace this day and forevermore. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.